Everybody, it's Victor. It's time for another run here, the Binding of Isaac, Victor Repentance series. Happy first of the month here in October, everybody. Can you believe it? We only have 2 months left in 2022, and then this year is over. Thankfully, mercifully over. Or maybe even, like, unfortunately over. I don't know. I've known a lot of people that had a lot of good years here in 2022, and I've known some people that this year wasn't all that great. But either way, one thing that is great is today's meme of the day. First off, thank you all very much for the support, as always. As far as the lost video is concerned, or the lost episode, I should say, we're still waiting for that one to clear. As soon as that one is done, I'll let everyone know via the community post. Here's your meme of the day, brought to you here by Headshot Queen. Title threat was adulting is hard. So many dead ends. Glad I know the expert on overcoming them. I know, even if I've been gone for some time, if I have a bad day, I can count on you to make it better. I can only assume they're talking about me, but thank you very much, Headshot Queen, and all 142 of you who uploaded that very wholesome meme of the day. I liked it a whole lot. Let's hop on in today and see what kind of Eden run we got going on. Today, we have Freezer Baby, as well as the D1, 6 Echo, 9 Echo, Sierra 3, Hotel 0. We've got Great Tears Raid. Oh, Curse the Blind. That's just super duper. And we start off with a wafer. 3.39 tears is amazing, along with 3.30 damage, which isn't that great on paper, but combined with the fact that we've got, like, you know, incredible... Dude, what is going on with these flies? These flies cannot... That was so weird. They could not decide on which way they're going to be rotating at. But combined with our tears rate, 3.30 damage, even though it is slightly below base Isaac damage, it is good enough to be considered pretty high this early on. You're seeing here the effect of Freezer Baby. Hey, well, we got two of them. Freezer Baby is going to freeze things that it touches and deals enough damage to be lethal, and then we can push the bodies like that and cause little fractals to kind of appear, and then those will also destroy things. Very good damage, actually, these little ice explosions. I think we'll go back into the store to see if there's a soul heart here now that we have 5 cents from the golden poop. And there is not. There is a golden pill, however, but there's also a 7 cent item for, like... I mean, I know it's Curse the Blind, but early on, I mean, yeah, I'll take a 7 cent item. I know what you're saying. You're saying it's Victor. You could have used a D1 on one of those coins. Yeah, I could have, but, like, also, what if a chest drops? Okay, well, I'll just use it on this coin here. There we go. There you go. No problem. 7 cents. No big deal. The D1 is going to pick something, one thing random on the ground that it can duplicate. Mom's bracelet. I mean, like, we could... If I really wanted to, we could take a pot. Actually, no, there's a bomb rock here. Okay, I'm going to take the... So I'm going to take the bomb rock and go attack Famine with it and immediately hit myself for the rest of my soul heart because I'm an idiot. I actually didn't think that it would actually, like, cause that much damage, that explosion radius. But you see right here, you can use Mom's Bracelet to do a variety of different things. Mainly, get the quarter in random freaking spots. But also, you can use it to pick up rocks and stones and stuff and use it for damage, as you saw me do there against Famine. Although, again, it did cost me my... Hang on. So I gotta see this. Okay. The D1, I mean, I do like the D1. You know what? Let's spice it up a little bit. We don't hardly ever use Mom's Bracelet. I think you can even use the rocks to get into secret rooms, if I recall that correctly. I might be misremembering that. I know that if they have bombs, we can use it like this one here. Now, let's not hit ourselves again, because we don't want to actually, like, you know, die, but do that. Throw a bomb there. We get a bomb anyway, so that's pretty neat. There's no obvious place for the super secret room or regular secret room, so we'll just head on down. Very, very chaotic start. We're coming away here with zero, and I mean zero soul hearts, but we do have a planetarium. Planetarium's been showing up times in a row now, and I'm fine with that. As long as it's a decent item. We can see what item it is, of course. Trying to get too fancy here with the trite. Yeah. Get a fire rate up here. Obviously, we do not want Mars, even though we would be able to get into the secret or the curse room for free. And out of there as well. It's not my intent to do so. We'll take the bomb rock, though. Yeah, so Mom's Bracelet lets you pick up a variety of environmental objects, as you've been seeing me do, and you can use them for damage. Obviously, the bomb rocks are a lot of fun to use because they lead off with a huge amount of damage. But more importantly, you can take a rock from the previous room and then use that as sort of like this projectile that you can, you know, then kind of get a leg up on the next room. It's like priming a kidney stone in a way. And we can take the pot over here and just throw them down the middle, you know, that kind of stuff. It's an interesting item. Again, it's not an item that you see me use all that often just because it never really presents itself as something that could be useful in most scenarios. But what I will say is it is nice not having to need bombs for practically anything other than secret rooms. And if we find a bomb rock, which I hope we find here. There you go. It's good enough to one-shot a champion. Hey, that's good enough for me. Wonder if we can pick up... Oh, okay. So I wonder if we could pick up a frozen enemy, but then they just disappeared. So another thing that we could do here, like this tinted rock, for example, we don't need to use bombs for them. We can actually pull double duty, and we're just going to keep getting just random items from our rocks and pots and stuff. All right. I mean, I'm down for it. Look, I'll take a damage upgrade and tears up. But if you really, really wanted to, you could conceivably take every rock on a level and min-max the crap out of it and look for a crawl space, because, you know, it's not guaranteed that you'll find a crawl space in every level, but there's a good chance you'll find one. Am I going to do that? No, because this video would be like 4 hours long, and I'm not going to do that. Even if we needed to do something like that, I still probably wouldn't do it. I'm just going to be honest. I don't have the patience to go do that, you know, every single time. We get small rock here again. Mom's Bracelet. Hey, you know what? That's just another item that we would not have gotten had we not taken it. So, some hidden utility maybe. I mean, look at this. We don't need bombs here to get these. And, I mean, if we really, again, wanted to, could take every single pot and just kind of, you know, yeet them around and see what kind of money we can get out of it. You know, there is the occasional spider, but if we get any spiders, we just throw the pot on the spider. And, yo, dog, I heard you like spiders, so we put a spider in your pot so you can spider while you spider. No soul hearts of any kind, unfortunately, so it looks like might have more angel deals in our future for us. See the very, very quick recharge time of Mom's Bracelet. I'm loving this tears rate, 4.62 with almost 5 damage. I mean, there's nothing to complain about right now. We're looking good. I was in a mood today. I was like, man, I really, really cannot wait to record Isaac today. I don't know why. Just something today. I don't know. Maybe I'm just going crazy today. I don't know. But I was like, and I really want to play Isaac today. I don't know why. Maybe it's because I didn't get a chance to play tonight on stream because I had to do a sponsored stream. I get an HP upgrade here from Red Dingle, and I will take Incubus. This fire rate, this is bound to be a huge, huge help for us. 2 extra cents for the key. Not really worth the cost of admission, but we'll take it. Literally better than nothing. I wonder if rocks can break that. Obviously, us having Incubus here is going to pull double duty with the tractor beam, as you see here. We effectively double our tears rate. Like, the amount... We literally double the amount of shots that we're firing here, thanks to Incubus. And again, Cricket's Body. Now, we do have to be careful when we throw mushrooms, because they will explode for bad gas. I think only bombs will be able to open that door. We do get Cricket's body, which is going to give us splash damage. But the thing is that because we have Tractor Beam, all of that damage, all those extra tiers and stuff, they will essentially get turned into just more projectiles that we have via the Tractor Beam. But thankfully, we get into a bedroom here, which is going to give us 3 free soul hearts. And this is not going to be a crawl space because it's a dirty bedroom. You know, there's going to be the one person out there like, wait a second here, buddy. I done seen me one of them crawl spaces in them dirty bedrooms. I'll say, well, listen here, Cletus. I have yet to see any crawl spaces in a dirty bedroom. In a clean bedroom, they're guaranteed, but not in a dirty bedroom. So until I am shown opposite of the fact, I will respectfully argue with that. Get 2 keys here for essentially free, so worth it for us to check out the stone chest. And we get the key back, a bomb, and a couple cents. Yeah, just the sheer amount. I mean, we essentially have 3 times the shots that we were shooting just a moment ago. Thanks to Incubus, and now, of course, thanks to Cricket's body. We'll take School Bag. School Bag kind of climbing up the ladder in terms of the power rankings. For me, anyway. Usually I don't like fiddling with extra space bar items in the micromanagement phase of it all, just because I'm lazy, but I've been... The last couple of times the school bag has shown up has proven to be quite worth it, so... Definitely an item that's worth consideration. In here, we don't have to worry about obstacles at all. We can just use the level against itself. Super Secret Room is south of here, 110,000% guarantee. And let's go back. I'm going to pick up this mushroom to see if we can get a bad gas explosion on the boss. Like something out of Mario 2 right now. We peep. Yeah, just look at the damage. We have, again, less than 5 damage here, but because it's the sheer amount of projectiles that we're firing makes it look like we have just incredible damage right now. No reason for us not to take the head of Krampus as well. We have the school bag and we'll head on Dizown. But man, we got something special here. Curse of the Maze. That is a problem there. You saw that little bounce back that the Mr. Mine did. Oh, gosh. Like some of these low-level horde that I'm beating up in World of Warcraft on Lauder. The Eternal Heart. Now, if we end up getting some kind of crazy tier effects here, we could be looking at something very unique. It's not often that we get Tractor Beam to actually have synergy with multi-shots. Especially for it to be this effective here with Incubus and Cricket's body. So this really is a unique combination that you don't get to see all that often. And trust me, I'm all for it. Secret Room's going to be here. I would have never known that had I not come back down here. Turns out I don't know it even if I did come back down here. Again, I really appreciate all the support and patience, everybody, for this last couple of days wonkiness with the copyright claim and all that stuff. It's still not cleared yet, but out of my control, there's not really much I can do about it. And what's funny now is, I kind of alluded to it in the community post as well, is it's like now when we do finally release the lost episode or the copywritten episode or the delayed episode, whatever you call it, the late episode, when I finally do release it, like, people are now going to, like, just expect it to be this amazing run and stuff. And I'm like, it wasn't really a special run, but I guess now it kind of is for a different reason. The wrong reason, but, when it does finally come out, I think people will, I think you'll be satisfied. I mean, it wasn't super crazy. It was just a regular old run. There was some highlights though. I will say that it was a better than average run. But now, because of the of everything that happened, now it's like people's hype levels are going to be just through the roof. Why did I think the secret room was there? Oh no, it was cursed. We have cursed the maze. Never mind. Like I must be going crazy if I thought the secret room was there. I can't be there either. Buddy in a box. And by get buddy in box, I mean leave it right the hell where it needs to be, which is right there. Gotta be careful of this room. They do that sort of BS where, you know, it's like, oh, we're gonna start you with these mobs that will shoot a tier directly at you as soon as you enter the room. If you're firing, which of course I'm always firing. You know, the nickel here. Actually, our money has not been a problem at all in this run. And for it being so early on here, you know, it's real nice. We're about to go into the mid-game stages here at Hallowed Ground, which is gonna give us the ability to have the Star of Bethlehem buff, essentially, is what it is. So yeah, really, really powerful start here. Well, I just wanted to see if maybe it was bustable from the inside of the secret room, but turns out it's not. That's okay. Now we did get a Guppy item, of course, and that is going to give us one of three for Guppy. And since we are, I mean, I'm kind of feeling a little risky. I think we can use Guppy's paw here on this one and only one red heart, give ourselves three more soul hearts, because we're going to get another one via the eternal heart on the next floor. Another curse of the maze. A little ridiculous now, I gotta say. Best thing here is you can throw skulls. Anytime we take damage, the hallowed ground or the holy poop will give us this white glowing aura surrounding the poop, and that will give us a massive amount of DPS as well as homing while standing inside of the aura of said aura. Unfortunately, there's no way for us to really get this chest without using a bunch of bombs, and I mean, one golden chest for that many bombs is kind of eh. Thinking nickel there. One bomb, I mean, we don't really need money right now, so unless we really need that nickel, I probably would just leave it alone. But one thing I like about Mom's Bracelet here is that it provides us with just enough burst damage to kill almost every mob that we come across. Almost. It's good enough to weaken them for sure. Look at this. We get a dice shard. The dice shard will give us essentially the D6 and the D20 effect. Pandora's box. Honestly, what does it give us right now? It gives us 4 soul hearts. That's pretty good. 4 soul hearts for 15 cents. That's hard to pass up. So technically only 3.5 soul hearts there, but that's okay. I could take tarot cloth if I really, really wanted to. I kind of don't though, because we have this dice shard. Hangman. Got a black poop here we can throw on Monstro. Reason why the dice shard factors into the tarot cloth equation is because it would re-roll something twice. And people seemed a little bit confused as to why I didn't want car battery along with the D6 in the other run. Another one we had earlier this week is, I don't remember which day. It may have even been yesterday, out for all I remember. You had the ability to have car battery, and I didn't take it because I don't want to burn through our item pedestals that fast. And there were more than a few people who were like, well, wait a second. Wouldn't it just help you get to something better, like faster? Not necessarily. You have to remember that when you roll something twice, it takes it out of the item pool, period. And you won't know what you've rolled past. So, you know, if you have any like targeted items that you're looking for, then maybe like, you know, like, oh, I can't wait for us to get a guppy item. Unbeknownst to you, you've rolled through it, and the next thing you know, you're SOL. Oh, that happens. If I can get a curseless floor here on depths 2, we need to make a little bit of a concerted effort here to get to boss rush, especially with going the wrong way. Start. So now here's where Dice Shard really comes into play is for boss rush. But the problem is that we can only use one and only one consumable there in that slot. So we have to decide now if we do boss rush, are we actually going to do boss rush? I think this build is strong enough too. It would definitely take a while, but with the head of Krampus, you know, that would cut things down quite a bit. So what I'm saying is that I'm not fully against the idea of boss rush. We just need to find it sooner than later. The dice room here, which is, I feel like it's gonna be a 5 room for some reason. I don't know why. Nope, it's gonna be a full reroll, which we are not going to do. Hookworm does give us a tears up, and we don't have to worry about Hookworm here because we have a tracker beam. Hookworm is just a straight up damage up. Typically, you would stay away from Hookworm, or at least I would anyway, because I don't want to be bogged down by the fact that my tears are doing everything that I don't want. Like, you're going in every which direction except the way that I want them to. And in typical Synvicta fashion here, we have gone the absolute wrong way every single time. Still have not even found the item room yet, so there's that. So let's stop taking so much damage from stuff that we shouldn't be taking damage from. So now we're getting to the situation scenario where we need to decide, is the reroll better than just skipping boss rush altogether? Had enough of Dr. Fetus for this month. Thank you very much. We use the reverse tower card in here. See if we can get a couple of tinted rocks. We did get one. And oh, there's a second one here. But we are not going to make boss rush here. Probably could have if I didn't drop the full card, or not full card, but the ice shard here. So, but it's unfortunate because we definitely had a chance to doing it, but going in the wrong direction literally every time that we made a directional decision was the death knell for that. And we may have made it there, but then we wouldn't have gotten the reroll, and that would have stopped. That would have defeated the whole point of us going for it. We'll take 4.5 volt here with Krampus's head. Mom's bracelet doesn't really benefit from that. Hive mind and broken stopwatch. Mine would have been fine, but. Go pretend I didn't see what that pill said. We have pH Dizzle, which is going to give us positive pill effects and also identify things. I gotta wait for all four. I don't know what hit me, but there we go. Good. finally get a damage upgrade here in the form of the negative, and we get sulfur. I mean, sulfur plus 4.5 volt is real OP. And I think we use the dice shard here. And I have a cult. I have a cult as good damage up. Take that. It's weird that I can stop the gears by changing directions. It's very interesting. And another Curse of the Blind. Oh man, now we got the wonky tears here with Brimstone. So what's nice about this build here with Brimstone, and or technically Sulfur, but with basically Brimstone, is the fact that with 4.5 volts, Sulfur will essentially always recharge, which means that we get access to a consistent and dependable damage up in basically every single room until the boss is dead. Which really opens up the possibility for synergies and whatnot. Yeah, we can do this. So our movement speed being negatively affected by small rock has hurt us a little bit. Bro. I was wondering why we got hit there, and that's the reason why, because it's a rainbow champion. Means that it has all the properties of every champion type possible, and they're all magnified. This is getting ridiculous. Wow, it took a full blast hit from Mom's bracelet. Wow, that's impressive. Another tower card. At the wafer, so this is only going to cost us half price to get in here. Get a full card and a world card, which shows us that we were going indeed the absolute wrong way you could possibly go. Why did that happen? Again, as I was talking about in the first floor, the jostling around, just because of the way that Isaac physics work, I use the term physics loosely there, but the way that it works is that the more shots that something has to bounce off of, the more erratic that their movement becomes. So we're going to be seeing enemies kind of just jostling all over the place and kind of jittering and whatnot. You gotta be careful of that, especially if they shoot projectiles. Again, want to control our damage here because I don't want three of these things exploding at once, making things infinitely more difficult to dodge. Out of this room in particular. The luck up pill again. The reason why everything is being identified is because we have pH Dizzle. We don't need perks because we already have the wafer. The triacnid. Okay, I actually think sulfur is kind of almost unnecessary, but we'll keep it for now. We get consolation prize. They give us a nice tears up. Let's see what that makes it after we get rid of sulfur. There's a lost here. So our base tears rate is now 6.06. Gertie. That is... Wow. Okay, Chubb. And charging enemies like these, for example, are another example of how we have to be very cautious with we're pelting out this many tiers at once. But I do think that the positives outweigh the negatives for sure. Just having the sheer amount of firepower that can just blitz anything down is really, really powerful in Isaac. And you're not even a glass cannon, you're a glass Gatling gun, basically. So being able to do that is, again, it's just a fantastic source of DPS. We've had minimal, I would say, damage upgrades tonight, or today rather, and we're mowing things down, no problem at all. I will say, piercing shots would be nice if we can get them, but at this stage of the run, I think that's going to be something that we're going to see, unless we get Death's Touch inside of the Devil Deal. You get our extra item room here, the courtesy of the crown, and I'm glad we finally found it, and I'd have to backtrack for it. And wait for the statue to fire, then we can go over the side. See what our extra item is going to be. It's going to be $3 bill. Sure, why not? Why not? I will confess right now that I'm not going to do a victory lap today. I have an engagement I have to go to. And I wanted to get this done before that. But we'll go fight Lamb and see if Delirium opens up. Maybe we fight Delirium. Maybe. We're going to get another tier effect here with Bookworm. That's just going to give us even more projectiles. Honestly, I think that we're done with Mom's bracelet. It did a great job for us, for sure. And we thank you for everything you've done for this organization. And hope for nothing but the best for you in the future and your future endeavors. And this is the wrong way. It's still the wrong way. Yo, again, we're still getting the little shots here and there from Freezer Baby. Oh, yeah, the 8.5 or the 8-inch nails, not 8.5-inch nails. Let's not be crazy. Let's not be stupid. I see the massive amount of damage that goes up here. Oh, we briefly had piercing shots for a second there. Yeah, this is what... Oh, look at that. Totally frozen, man. Just pelting Mom's heart with a ridiculous amount of shots. Take Guppy's Eye, our second Guppy item. Yeah, let's go see Old Hushy. Since we're not doing a victory lap... Go see Old Hushy, just for you all. You have enough keys for this, so I think it's worth it. Baby Bender, Matchbook, and Ace of Something. Diamonds. Yeah, why not?
Ace of Diamonds.
I guess Lost Fly? Oh man, we got to go Sinus Infection here. Sinus Infection is going to be huge. You get another Tears Up and Shot Speed up here, courtesy of the Screw. Now, 6.81 tears per second. And unfortunately, we're not going to get anything else out of this. But hey, you can still put money back in the donation bank. I don't know if we got over to 900. It looked close. You might be saying to yourself, you sulfur. Reason why you got it. Well, I don't want to use sulfur now that we have sinus infection because it's actually going to give us more DPS to stack up the dots rather than give us like an incremental damage up every, you know, minute or so. Maybe less than a minute. Every like 20 seconds or so with the 4.5 volt and sulfur. Sinus Infection you've seen here just dealing constant damage with those boogers on Hush, old Hushy. Currently firing after Lost Fly, I think. Oh, there. I don't know why that's... Not sure why those tears came out so much faster than the other ones he usually does. Like we've gotten either Inner Eye or we've gotten a Mutant Spider now. This is where Tractor Beam actually hurts us because we don't have any homing. And unfortunately, Hallowed Ground dropped in a spot where we cannot use it against Hush. Oh, maybe we can right here. We found the sweet spot. Now we definitely can. Sometimes the waterfalls don't hit you, and sometimes they, like sometimes they just swirl around you, and sometimes they won't. Another reason why I don't mind fighting Hush here is basically because we have the wafer, and all the damage is half price. So I'm fine. I'm not fine with taking the damage that we did, but it doesn't endanger us in any way. Alright, Book of Secrets is going to show us the map, and it looks like we have a long way to go to get to Stanley. Tended Rock in here. What are your plans for the weekend, Mosh Pit? You got any new games you're playing? Are any of you leveling up in WoW? Are any of you opening up some Star Wars cards or anything like that? I love hearing that kind of stuff. Keeps things relatable and fun. And just gives me something to read. Like hearing about the real people that make up the Mosh Pit. Happy Zai didn't lie to us this time for once. Flaming hot in here. Talk about those flaming hot Cheetos. Are you talking about those flaming hot Cheetos? I mean, I already have kind of talked about them. It's weird because I'm such a pansy when it comes to spiced foods, but then when it comes to like flaming hot Cheetos, I don't eat them that often, but every now and then I'm like, man, like that, like something tangy and spicy sounds good. That's the only tangy and spicy thing that I actually like can eat without like dying. I'm down with the spicy hot. Give me the flaming hot Cheetos. I'm down with them. Sign me up. I can't eat a lot of them at a time because it does actually hurt my stomach. But we are gonna get Guppy here, and we also get Death's Touch as well. And sure, Pogatory, you can come too. Why not? Wow. Okay. Game's like, are you sure you don't want a victory lap? Yes, unfortunately, I'm sure. I am sure. I have a prior engagement. us be done. No, it's not. It's not like a date or anything. Dinner plans with friends. It's always good to get out of the house. I've been playing way too much World of Warcraft lately, so anytime I can get out of the house, this is gonna be good. Wow, that dead end right there would have driven me nuts. Thinking that, oh, we're going in the right way. Nope. It's the Book of Secrets. Now we know. Having these piercing shots is huge for us. Fracture beam, especially with Cricket's body still attached here to all these multi-shots. Heavy helps out as well, I suppose. It's just the best transformation in the entire game. I suppose it helps. I guess. And that is some serious, serious damage we're packing here. All right, here we go. So let's see if we get old Delirium or if Lamb is just going to be its. Lamb couldn't even move. I think we did get a Delirium portal. We did, so we're not through yet here. We're going overtime. We are in the void. And obviously the Book of Secrets is going to help us out greatly here as soon as we get the map effect. Not Mass Effect, but map effect. Two different things. I will readily and safely confess that I've never played any of the Mass Effect series at all. Ever. Ever. Ever.
Tears up.
I'm not, it's so weird because I don't like open world games, and I know that it's not open world, but you know what I mean, like the epic single player experience games. You know, like I played Skyrim is the only one that I played that I enjoyed. I played Skyrim way, way, way back in the day. But I tried Fallout, I didn't like any of the Fallouts. You know, God of War looked pretty cool, but you know, I think I'm gonna like try. I never played any of the Uncharted. I never played the new, like, you know, Tomb Raiders and that sort of thing. I guess they're not new anymore. But those type of games I've just never meshed well with. I don't know why. We were able to see the entire floor here. Not sure how much help that's going to be, but the swarm here from Daddy Longlegs. Just look at that damage. 9 volts as well. 9 volts not going to matter all that much. I mean, it will give us a full charge, obviously, on the Book of Secrets, but I feel this Delirium here. Oh, be frail. All right, so there's the entire west side of the map. Now let's move on down, I guess, to the south side. Again, as you can see on paper, like, our damage really isn't anything that's like super impressive, but it really is hard to tell just the sheer magnitude of the amount of shots that we're firing here because of Tractor Beam. And that's ultimately what's giving us this huge amount of strength as well. It's just that we're pumping out ridiculous amounts of shots. Stupendous amount of shots, I would even say. But And again, as I was saying earlier as well, is that, you know, having these piercing shots will make a lot of difference. If we get spectral tears, that'd be even cooler. The car battery here. Car battery is good for sulfur as well as for the Book of Secrets, but we're already maxed out on the Book of Secrets usage. This, we can hangman. We already have flight with Guppy, so we don't really need to worry about that. Uphill? I didn't. Was that another tears uphill? Oh my gosh! Ridiculous. Now we're definitely tears capped at 7. And because of, if you might be saying like, wait a second here, I thought it was at 5.5 or 5 or something like that. Well, remember we got Cricket's body as well. Cricket's body reduces the or increases the tears cap. It goes beyond it, plus ultra style. So we're now firing 7 times a second. That is just, that's just a stupid amount of tears. Priestess, no thank you. And we're going to do our typical Sinvicta thing and go to the last possible location of Delirium. I already know it's going to be the one to the southeast, but... Whee! All right. Got one sticky nickel. I'm not giving you a second one. Just in the off chance that we get money with power somewhere. As a champion, stay alive that long. Yep. There you go. There's basically no. No. Do not need a tears up anymore, and I don't want to drop our damage. Even though we don't have a lot of damage, it's still a decent amount. It's certainly not worth dropping by, you know, 30% or whatever Skinny on Mushroom does at this point. With diamonds, doubles our key, or doubles our coins, not keys. Making our way to the final boss of the entire game here with Delirium. So what a run it's been, man. What a run. It was an enjoyable experience with a synergy that we don't get to see all that often. And again, if you want to see the synergy for yourself, then definitely play the seed. What the heck are we getting hit by? Delirium doing Delirium things. Dude, seriously? I mean, I know our movement speed's like not that great, but like, this is getting out of hand with how many shots we've been hit by. I cannot wait for, well, let's be honest, they'll never fix Delirium, but this is why you go fight Delirium only if you really want to, if it's optional. I mean, obviously you got to get him for the post-it note unlocks, but you know, either way, thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. I really would appreciate it. And like I said earlier, let me know what you're doing this weekend down below. If you're playing new games, or you're collecting cards, you're watching football, I'd love to know. And thank you again for the support and understanding, everyone, for the last couple of days. And also, one final time, I hope everyone who's been impacted by Hurricane Ian, I hope you're safe and sound. Or if you're about to get hit by the now tropical storm, make sure you're staying safe. And I hope that friends and loved ones and property are safe and sound. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like RickRue59, McMannon, Barbecue Sauce Mix, Medic Wolf, Squeegee, and T. Ryan. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.